Hi guys, welcome you all to my channel Explore Edu to Teach.
The next topic that we'll be learning today is maximum power transfer theorem. So basically, as we learned the other theorems like Thevenin's theorem, superposition theorem, Norton's theorem, this is another theorem that is a maximum power transfer theorem. This basically is used for finding out the maximum power that is delivered to the load resistance in the given circuit diagram. Okay, so let's dive into it. Let's try to understand what is maximum power transfer theorem, and then we'll try to apply the theory that we are learning onto the numerical as we have done for other theorems. If you haven't watched the earlier theorems and if you're interested, please go and watch out those theorems. It is there in my network playlist on my YouTube channel. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel and share this video to as many as you can so that everyone can get benefited out of it. Thank you so much. So let's begin up with the theorem. So the maximum power transfer theorem deals with the transfer of maximum power from the source to the load. So what is the source? Source is this part and the load is this part. So the maximum power transfer deals with the transfer of maximum power from the source to the load when the load resistance is made equal to the equivalent resistance of the network as viewed from the load terminals, with the load removed, replacing all the sources with their internal resistances. So what does this theorem state? It states that the maximum power can take place from source to the load when the equivalent resistance from the AB terminal will be equal to the load being removed, that is the RL will be open, and my voltage sources and current sources will be either indicated by their internal resistances, or as we have always done, the voltage source is being short circuited and the current source will be open circuited. I hope I am very clear with this. So to summarize the maximum power transfer, it says that the maximum power can be transferred from the source to the load when the equivalent resistance from the load terminal end will be equal to the load resistance being removed, okay, and the voltage source and the current source will be represented by the internal resistances, or the voltage source will be short circuited and the current source will be open circuited. So this is a theoretical language for it. When we do a numerical, you will understand better. So if I have to talk about the maximum power transfer, here will be RL will be equal to RTH. How? As I told you, we have to find out the equivalent resistance from the AB end. I am going to keep my RL open, as I mentioned, and the voltage source will be short circuited, and there is no current source. Had there been a current source, I would have kept it open circuited. So in that way, my RL is equal to RTH. I hope I am very clear. So the maximum power transfer is equal to VTH square upon 4 times RTH. If you know about Thevenin's theorem, you will be knowing about these terminologies. VTH is the Thevenin's voltage and RTH is the Thevenin resistance. If you haven't watched that video, please go and watch it out on Thevenin's theorem. You will get a better understanding about it. Okay. So now let us take a numerical on the same. So the numerical says, find the maximum power transfer through RL. Okay, my load resistance. How am I going to solve this question is step 1. Okay, so what I am going to do in step 1 is I am going to find out the VTH. Why I am going to find out VTH? Because my maximum power transfer formula is VTH square upon 4 times RTH. That means I'll have to find out VTH, I'll have to find out RTH, and then VTH square upon 4 times RTH. I hope I'm very clear. So first we'll try to find out the VTH. So for VTH, what we are going to do is, we are going to keep this load resistance terminal open as we have kept it over here, and we have to find out this VTH or the VAB. Okay. So in order to find out this, there are many techniques. You can apply the mesh analysis, nodal analysis, so many techniques. We'll try to apply the nodal analysis and try to find out the value of my VA, which is equal to VTH. So reducing this diagram onto this, let us see what I have done. I applied the source transformation theorem over here. I have converted the parallel current source with a resistance into a voltage source with a series resistance. So the voltage source 125 volt comes from 25 into 5, and the 5 ohms which is in parallel becomes in series. I have 10 ohm resistance, I have 10 amperes current, I have 2 ohm resistance, I have 10 ohms resistance, I have 30 volts voltage source. So I'm going to find out VA, because my VA is parallel to my 10 ohm current source. So let us try to find out the VA, because the VA will be equal to VTH. I hope I'm very clear how I've reduced this particular circuit diagram onto my this circuit diagram. Now this VB value is equal to 30 volts directly, right? My VB is directly connected to 30 volts. So I can say VB is equal to 30 volts. I have to find out VA. So for that, I'm going to apply nodal analysis. So what am I going to do is here, I'm going to assume my current to be outgoing. So it is VA minus 125 upon 5 plus 10 is 15. Because V by R is equal to current. And since my current is assumed to be outgoing, I'm taking VA minus 125 upon 15. Plus minus of 10. Why I'm taking minus of 10? Because I'm assuming the current to be outgoing. Since it is incoming, if I want to take it outgoing, it should be minus of 10. Similarly, VA minus 30 upon 2 equals 0. Try to find out the value of your VA. The VA value will be equal to my VTH value. I hope I am very clear with this. Okay. The next thing is to find out the value of RTH. So, why RTH? Because my maximum power transfer formula is VTH square upon 4 times RTH. VTH is a Thevenin voltage. RTH is my Thevenin resistance. So in this thing, what have I done? I always told you, what you need to do is, you need to keep this load resistance terminal open and short the voltage source and open the current sources. So if I do this over here, I've kept my load resistance open. I have kept the 25 amperes current source, 10 amperes current source open, and I have shorted my 30 volts voltage source. Okay. So what happens is that when I keep a short in parallel with a resistance, this 10 ohm resistance becomes redundant. Okay. Hence 10 ohm is redundant since it is in parallel with a short circuit. Therefore, I can keep this 10 ohm as open. Hence, my RAB will be a 10 plus 5, 15 parallel to, which is 1.76 ohms. Okay. So, the maximum power transfer is VTH square upon 4 times RTH. This is my maximum power transfer to my load resistance. I hope I am very clear with this. So, this is my theorem. So, I'll just summarize to you. So, maximum power transfer theorem states that maximum power can be transferred from the source to the load when my equal resistance from the AB terminal will be equal to the resistance viewed from AB terminal with the voltage source being shorted and the current source being open. And in this case, if I consider the value of RAB, voltage source is shorted, load resistance is open, my RAB is equal to RTH. Hence, the maximum power transfer is VTH square upon 4 times RTH. Now, there is a question in which you are finding out the maximum power transfer through RL. So, I am going to keep the RL open. Try to find out VA, which is equal to VTH. You can use any particular method. I am using nodal analysis over here. The method is completely solved. Try to find out the value of VTH, or the value of VA will be equal to the value of VTH. The RTH will be, keep this resistance open, open the current sources, short the voltage source, and try to find out the value of RAB equal to RTH. And my maximum power transfer is going to be VT square upon 4 times RTH, and try to find out the answer. So I hope I am very clear with this. So if you like the video, please give a big fat like in the comment section. Do like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Follow me on Instagram and share it to as many people as you can, so that maximum people can get benefited out of it. Thank you so much. God bless you.